REZ-2023-06. Mr. Dillon.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Again, Commissioners, this is a request by Hershey Family Entertainment, doing business with Wild Adventures, to amend the previously approved site plan. Current zoning is PD. The future zoning will remain PD with an accompanying site plan. As noted, Wild Adventures is a regional activity center and depicted such in the future land use map. And you do recall some wetlands here, mainly the pond in the center of the two properties and the adjacent wetlands on the southeast portion of the properties. Now, back in 1995, this was the approved site plan for Wild Adventures. When it came before as Liberty Farms, what they recognizable more or less is the pond in the middle. And you can see a few of the options there, including more wildlife, native activities, small lodging, and a few conference centers. Part of the conditions for approval did include overnight lodging and group accommodations, as highlighted here, and bed and breakfast and other types of lodging. So the initial plan did include for the lodging. They're just now specifying it out in this updated site plan. You'll also note some of the other activities, including food and beverage service, concessions, hunting and shooting, which was unique. So somebody really wanted to call one of the pictures on it. They could look back to the original 1995. But this is the overall site plan today, as Wild Adventures most of us know. And there's a lot more detail of the rides. On the left-hand side of the screen up there, you'll notice the land that they are proposing to add the campground to, which is here in the dark gray portion. It'll include RV sites, glamping sites, and traditional tent sites, as well as some few amenities, such as dump stations, comfort stations. The light gray area in the top northwest is a future phase three, just thinking long-term. Zoomed in here, again, it includes more campsites, RV sites, and again, restaurants, splash pad, playgrounds, mini golf, or other side amenities. Again, this is their long-range plan. They want to go ahead and show it here. So, we'll now move down to the existing, what they're proposing for phase one and phase two. You see the campsites there. You see the camp store. Again, improved access with driveways and a pedestrian walkway to the rear of the park. Even further south again, you see a few more sites. Some rental cottages are shown there. Those are phase two, with expected construction to take approximately 18 months, according to their engineer. And again, you notice the dump station and dumpster pad down there at the bottom, tying into the existing Wild Park exits. Here's a rendering from their own website. You notice the park there lit up at night. This is looking from the southwest to the northeast. And you can see some of the campground there on the bottom. Overall, again, staff reviewed this. TRC had no additional comments, noting that they do are on county utilities. And again, any additional standards will be caught during plan review for construction in the future phases.
Thank you, JD.
Any questions?
Just take a short pause here. There's someone at the door who can't have Thank you, JD. Commissioners, any questions for staff?
Do phase one and two, are they going concurrent?
More or less.
Okay.
Phase one and two are going concurrently, just as they develop it out.
Okay.
And they expect to hopefully break ground in July 1, and more or less be an 18-month process to fully complete, based on their timeline.
Awesome.
And during plan review, that's when all of the landscaping requirements and everything.
Correct. They are proposing more or less a 50-foot underserved buffer around the western edges. Again, there's an existing 8 to 10 foot fence, if you recall, so some of that can go in addition, but the landscaping will be brought into check for compliance, make sure it's improved.
Any other questions for staff?
No.
That being the case, we will now enter the public hearing portion on this application. Is there anyone here this evening that would like to speak in favor of this application? If so, please come forward and set your name and address for the record. Seeing or hearing no one, is there anyone here this evening who would like to speak against this case? If so, please come forward, state your name and address for the record. There being no one for either side of the debate, that closes the public hearing portion on this case. Commissioners, any other discussion? Then I will entertain a motion for approval or not.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes, Commissioner.
regarding this case, REZ-2023-06. This plan and request has been reviewed. It's not consistent with the comprehensive plan and existing land use. And I would like to make a motion that we recommend approval.
Thank you. We have a recommendation of approval by Commissioner Wiles. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Seconded by Commissioner Miller. All those in favor of the motion to approve, please raise your hand. If that's unanimous.